Welcome to the Slide Against Tech Simplified channel. And within today's video, I will be covering how to create a Microsoft 365 anti-malware policy. So stay locked in and watch this video to the end. First thing we need to do is go to admin.microsoft.com. Once we get here, select security, and then let's go to threat management, and let's go to policy, and let's go to anti-malware. And then right now I could either create a new policy, or in this case I'm just gonna edit the default policy. I'm not gonna change the name, and I'm not gonna update the description. So let's go straight into configuring this policy for anti-malware within Office 365. So I'm gonna select yes and use default notification text. This selection allows you to notify your end users if you're an MSP provider, or if you're an actual user of the software, notify your actual employees of that we found something malicious that we think is an attachment. We're gonna do some further analysis, but it's being quarantined for right now. So this is great to set the expectations, but you gotta know who your target customer is and how receiving this information is gonna affect them. Will it increase your IT bandwidth, because now your employees are nervous that maybe they clicked on something? Or do you think this will help them set the expectations so they know that the email was taken care of by the IT team? So just pick the choice that you want. And you can always change the notification to text that you preferably want to have, right? The next thing is you can also turn on the next feature to block attachments that may harm your computer, right? So let's turn that on. And we got the option here to add some more file types, so take away some file types. So Microsoft starts you off with a few, but you can also click on add and add whatever file type that you think that you need to be in and block there as well. So the malware 0 hour auto purge, I really like this one. Why? Because I had a customer who didn't have this feature, right? They didn't have Office 365 with the advanced threat protection, so they didn't have this ability to use Zap. So or 0 hour auto purge, right? So if Microsoft finds in your environment that a message has already been labeled as malicious, it automatically, retroactively, removes all the other instances of that in your tenant. So this is a good feature that you just want to have on, and it's pretty slick. So then you can also send notifications to internal senders and external senders that, you know, this message haven't been delivered, and you can choose if you want to do that or not. So if you do, they give you the option to update the actual message that you want to leverage. And you can also customize the notification. So let's click save. And now you just had created and edited an anti-malware policy within Office 365. Look how simple that was. Look at all the richness in terms of the policy creation. This is a really good tool to leverage in your environment if you're being plagued with phishing attempts. And I know especially during COVID-19, those phishing attempts are up through the roof. So this is something you definitely want to turn on and activate if you haven't already. So let's keep going. I'm gonna talk about what's the next steps you can do to continue to grow your knowledge with my channel and other resources.
You just finished learning all about creating a Microsoft 365 anti-malware policy. Now what I need you to do is keep that learning going. Learn about Microsoft 365 security. Learn about Azure security. Learn about IT careers and certifications. And you can do that all by subscribing and staying notified to my channel, because each and every week I'm creating new content just for you. So until next time, Sly Gittins is out.